This academy because I wanted to prepare for my portfolio, and we are having this exhibition, The Hill, which we painted the pains and joys of the hill. So every artist has expressed their own pains and joys, and here I have my works, and so here I have five works which I've named after the five elements of earth. And each name goes after a female person whom I admire, whom I look up to. I have worked in mediums like acrylics, oil pastels, oils. I've also worked in pencil colors, and these are my works. So every work here, I'll name it. Yeah. So this painting is Bhumi. I've named after the goddess of earth. Then this work is after Veni Amata. Then there are those two works, space and water. So every work, every texture of mine shows the pains and joys. You know, every texture depicts an emotion for me. So I've worked a lot with textures. I have experimented with mediums also. Here, as you can see, I have one work here. So there are three to four mediums that I've worked in here. And this painting's name is Ujwala, that means fire. So the medium that I've worked here is charcoal. I've worked in oil pastels, oil paints. So all of them are somehow related to fire, so that way. And then I do some sketches here. I have these sketches these are some sketches that these are sketches that I've done it in bus. All of them standing. So these are some of the sketches that I've done, all of them standing. And then I have these four works, two in harmony. So the name of these works are like two in harmony. So I've shown two people in harmony with different emotions and different phases of life, with every color depicting a different their phase of life that way. And then there are these four set of another. So these are named of relationships, good and bad. So it's a relationship between two people. It can be between a man and a woman and a woman, between two people. So relationships, like I've depicted the goods and the bads with the help of textures and colors. So in these I have experimented with the watercolors and oil pastels. And then I have these are purely watercolors that I've worked in. And then this one work that I've worked with Micron, and that is just with one medium. So that's why I name it Vritta, that means the universe. So it kind of sums up all the works in this work. So every work of mine talks about a female person. So that way, like how female in today's world are so uplifting and they are so outgoing. So I've, you know, compared every element of Earth to every element of Earth to every female that have come across in my life.
So how do you feel to be in this exhibition today?
We are very, 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 very glad to be here. I mean, I'm so happy that I'm a part of this exhibition. It is, and we feel very lucky to have come across this art academy. We worked all very hard for this exhibition.
How long it took you to paint?
So for this particular exhibition, we have worked in 1.5 months. So all these works that you see in this whole of the exhibition, all the artists have worked in 1.5 months. That's it.
And to finish up this each art development, how long it takes?
So it depends on the style, the texture. For example, my work I've taken a week, more than a week for every work. Around 10 days for every work I've taken. And the big canvas that you can see here, I've taken two to three weeks for my work I'm talking.
And so what do you want to say to the viewers? What do you want to give the message to the viewers?
The message that I want to give is, as you can see, our topic is pains and joys. So I want to tell you all viewers that we have expressed our pains and joys in these works. And yes, art can as well express the pains and joys. So there are other different forms of art, but here we have tried to express it with just colors and a canvas. So we've put in all our heart and all our emotions in these works, expressing our pains and joys.
So it's all females together that you are.
My work, yes, all females. We all female artists have come together, and yes, we are putting a strong message to the society that art is so strong enough that we can express our pains in the form of art. We can express, we can write down our emotions, not only in the form of words, but in the form of colors and textures. That wings.
Thank you.
and I'm an artist. We have put together this exhibition where I have tried to capture the moments which are fleeting, which are obvious, but people fail to notice it. And I feel these moments are so powerful that if they are predicted, if they are portrayed in a portrayed with full intention, it can change one's outlook towards life. And as you can see in my collection, I have a little story behind every picture that I have made. It's all from my personal experiences, the people I interact with, my everyday life situations. That's like, I have painted a girl with a butterfly on her hand. I have tried to equate the fleeting butterfly, which is very momentary, that she will fly away. I've tried to equate that with the childhood of the girl. Both have wings, ready to take a flight. But is it the butterfly or her childhood? Is what I've tried to say in that picture. This picture is about the bonding between sisters. While sisters grow up in a family, they are all of different ages. The elder one is responsible for the younger one. But as they grow up, the difference kind of dilutes. The difference doesn't exist. They all become each other's friends, each other's confidant, and they share their joys and pains. So since our topic of the exhibition is the hill, and a depiction of joys and pains, I have tried to put together a collection where you can see all of it. So for me, one emotion which has equal pain and equal joy is motherhood. And this is what I have tried to depict here, where I have tried to show that mother is always connected to their children. The relationship is simple, but at times complicated as well. The umbilical cord that they have when the child is born is always there, whether you see it or not. The mother would always be connected to their children. And that's how this work has come together. This is inspired by my own story of my mom, who has been always, you know, missing her friend in another city, but never could make it, never could get the opportunity to just travel to meet a friend. Like, it was kind of a luxury for them to meet to another city just to meet a friend in a woman's world. So I tried to depict that, and this painting is called Saudade, which is a Portuguese word which means longing to meet. I can this work is of a little girl who doesn't know how to read numbers and times, but she knows when it is 5 o'clock on the clock, when it's 5 p.m. because that's the time when she's allowed to go out, play in the open, and run and somersault in the sand. She very closely guards her playtime. She waits for it every day. I've tried to capture that moment where she's waiting. This is from my trip to Jaipur, to Nahargarh Fort, where people go to see the city lights. But when I had that hard climb and I reached on top of it, I was mesmerized by the sky. And the thought that came to my mind was probably Van Gogh was going through the similar experience when he made his Starry Nights. He wanted to capture that moment. And I have made stars a little bit like Van Gogh, trying to connect it with my experience here. And this, I have tried to show the joys of a child's life. As we have heard, there is no angry way of saying bubble. So it's a joyful activity when they do it. And I have tried to depict their imagination here. When I ask her, like, what are the bubbles for? And she says, for making a rainbow. And when I ask, how is it made? She says, it starts with me. I blow rainbows, send them up in the sky. When they float in the clouds, they collect together in a row and they weave into a rainbow. So that is my entire collection of 8 paintings here.
Just tell me, what made you as an artist? Are you a professionally artist or what do you do?
No, I have professionally not studied art. It's only in Pied Piper in last 2 years that I have studied, I have learned. Before that, I'm from a fashion background. I used to work in the field of fashion. Somewhere I wanted to pursue it very seriously, and I decided that it's time. I didn't want to be working in a corporate world all my life. I wanted to explore what all I have inside me and give a chance to my potential. I've always been interested, but I never got the correct, a right opportunity to express more, to learn more, to develop my skills, which I'm getting now, and I'm going to pursue it and make it my career.
How do you see this platform that you have today with all your previous friends? What exactly will you see?
I would say that this brings a lot of seriousness to how people perceive my work. Because when they see me, a lot of people think that I'm doing it just for time pass or as a hobby. But when I get a platform like this where I'm putting up a serious show together with other four artists, it means that I'm going to pursue it very seriously and I'm serious about it. It's just not a time pass hobby for me. It is something that makes me happy. It's a very important part of my life.
If given a chance, what would you like to choose, a fashion?
I've already done fashion designing. I've done it for 15 years. I have worked in that field. I've seen that side. So I want to explore this now. I feel very grounded and happy when I'm connected to it. The experience is almost meditational when I'm painting. I don't realize how many hours have passed. The time just passes by. And that makes me happy. I don't worry. There's no worry in it.
And what's the message that you want to get?
It's never too late to explore and to get back to what really makes you happy. That's the crux of the matter. It doesn't matter how much money you are making. It doesn't matter where you are living. You have to understand your inner desire, your inner self. What is important to you? What makes you happy? What is it that you can do endlessly for 18 hours or 24 hours without getting tired? Excites you every other day just the same way.
For about almost 2 months now, and I was asked to participate in this exhibition, which is called The Hill. So that's depicting the joys and pains of everyday life.
So what is so important in your drawings that you have?
So in all of my drawings, I try to portray my mental state or emotions at that point in time. So when you think about joys and pains, it's like every human emotion can be classified into either a pain or a joy. So depending on my mental state at the moment, I made all of these artworks to reflect the different emotions that I was feeling at that point.
What's the exhibition that you have put up together?
Yeah.
What made your mind to do?
I'm sorry?
What made your mind to put this exhibition together?
So honestly, I had just joined this art class and this came as an opportunity, and I thought it was an amazing like opportunity to like learn and display my art to the world. So I thought it was a really good chance for me to kind of hone my skills and be able to display them at the same time.
And what texture that you use to do painting, or this is sketch, or watercolors, what?
So this is actually a mixture of a lot of things. Both of these are oil pastel, that is just pencil. This is acrylic. this is oil paints, this one. And this one is watercolor with oil pastel on it, and that is oil paint as well. So it's like a mixture of mediums.
This is your professional that you are doing painting, or what is it? Like your passion?
Yes, it is more of a passion than a profession at the moment. Hopefully it will become a profession soon. But yeah, my background is like I'm an engineer, and then I did management, and I was working in finance. But I realized it wasn't really giving me pleasure, so I decided to quit and kind of pursue my passion, which is art.
So if it was not your passion, this profession, you would be like to be a full-time artist? Or?
Yes, I would love to be a full-time artist. Yeah, that's what I'm working towards. So.
What a message that you want to give to your viewers regarding your work or whatever you want to say?
I would say don't be afraid to express yourself in whatever way you want to. Just don't be afraid to think and like introspect and really get to know yourself and then be able to express it to the world. I think that's a superpower that everybody should have.
So today we see all females together putting out this. What was the motto of the things? What was the really concept that you have in mind to put this exhibition together?
The concept that we had in mind for this exhibition was like, yeah, it was just the to depict like the pains and joys that we face in life, that we've overcome, and that we, and a lot of people, and since it is a bunch of women now, it's like we as women experience navigating through daily life. So just like expressing that, that was kind of the motto.
So you're happy with the exhibition?
I'm very happy with the exhibition, yeah.
By profession, and and also come from a business background. But I've come here after all my career struggles, and I'm finally here pursuing my passion, which is art, which is painting. And this is my first exhibit, and it has been really exciting. So a little bit about my work. So my work is a reflection of my emotions and my imagination. Each work has been done in a single sitting in order to put the rawness of my emotion and my imagination together onto the paper or canvas. Today I have exhibited portraits, and a little bit of me is there in every portrait here. Please have a look.
How long did it take to have this exhibition put together, all these pictures?
So we all artists came together for 1.5 months. This whole work, the works have been done in the span of 1.5 months, which is about 40 days. So, yeah.
So what is your main art of drawing? Is this canvas drawing? What is it?
I'm comfortable with most of the materials, but what I'm in these 40 days, I worked a lot with oil on canvas, charcoal, and acrylics. And yes, and my style is days are oil on canvas, charcoal, acrylic, and watercolor. And the message about what was the question?
Yeah, what's the message that you would like to give from this art?
The message is that I think live life to full potential and just be happy in the present.
Since you said you were with a dentist,
yes.
So given a chance, what would you like to choose to be artist or dentist?
I mean, I've got that chance, so I picked art because that's my passion. So I have left dentistry to pursue my passion.
And so today you all are being together to put this with all females friends together.
Yes.
So what exactly made you want to have this exhibition? Where your first exhibition that you have? This is your first exhibition?
This is our first exhibition. And yeah, we all worked really hard in these past 40 days and put together a show and exhibited our works. A lot of effort went into it. And we really have a good bond, all of us. And the environment was great to work in and grow well. So yes, it was. So
can you tell us one thing about your painting which you did with more to your heart?
The painting closest to my heart is this one. This painting is the closest to my heart, which is called Glowing in the Dark. It's this one.
Yeah, that's one.
So this is oil on canvas and is a figurative abstract. So this is a self-portrait in which I'm trying to show that I have left everything behind to pursue in art finally, and I'm not going back. I'm here to finally pursue my passion. So this is the confident me who's made up my mind and has found my true passion.
The first time I visited an art gallery in my life, I'm in mid-30s, and what I see is each and every painting is different, vivid, and the creativity of each and every artist is coming out. Like for example, this abstract painting here by my friend Sandhya is very good, and likewise my sister has done some really amazing abstract work right there, some very strong strokes which shows her anger and her calmness, everything in one frame. And there are some beautiful paintings here also. Extreme detailing, as we can see in Meenakshi's paintings. It's great to be here. And I hope all you artists, this is the first and the smallest beginning you all can get. And like they say, when a rocket is propelled, it can reach up to Mars. So the sky is not even your limit. Even the solar system is not your limit. All the best.
Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Just explain, tell us about this exhibition, how you had it planned.
The first thing I'll say is, of all the years I've been teaching, I think this is the best group, most serious kind of work. Each one has done some, a unique body of work, which is, I can say, worthy of even the qualified artists. We have only one Nunnal who's qualified, but I think this is the best month, the best of works. what happens at my academy is each one is, you know, the best is brought out from each. So it's not like a classroom method, and I don't think any amateur class will have work like this original. It'll always be, you know, fruits, flowers, or you know, the technical kind of gimmicky work. So here it's all original.
So what about this exhibition that has put?
Okay, the hill. We named it the hill. We could plainly say, like, you know, the cliche term that ups and downs, but we called it the hill because you climb up, the struggle is nice sometimes, then you reach there. From there you decide whether you want to stay there, work hard, or you come down. You can come down gracefully or do something wrong and you tumble down, like a Sisyphean kind of this conundrum. So each one took the theme in their own way, which I feel common people won't understand. They'll wonder where is the hill, where is the struggle. But it's all in them, even in their abstract, even in Meenakshi's work. It's all about a family. In Divya's work you see, you know, personalities coming. Mrunal's work you see women. And Divya comments you see a lot of, you know, I don't know whether she'll agree, but there's a lot of morosity and, you know, sorrow. I see a lot of sorrow. She may not know that, but that's what the inner self has come out.
So how it was working with, you have this group with student to the professionals then?
What I like most is, 99% is amateur. It was their talent, and you can mold them easily. And it's not I'm forcing something on them. That's why you see the diversity. Otherwise, they would be all painting like me. Every age, see, Meenakshi, like, the only thing I tell them, if you're doing a portrait, don't do it like an ordinary portrait, which represents, or, you know, is a replica of a person. Get it to the soul, so you see her family. In Sanya's work, I rate Sanya as one of the best in the world as abstract, and she's just 18. She's just 18, and anyone will know that quality as something much higher level. Mrunal also agrees. She's done BFA. Not that she has not been taught anything, but they put you in a mold, and after you're done, like, you just go. From here, I want it to be a threshold. They move on and have nice shows, solo shows. And every medium is taught, you know, the best of the medium. Because I'm a practicing artist, but if I show you my works, you'll see nothing of their works a reflection of me.
Hello, I'm Sanya, and well, for today I've done some abstract art for exhibition at the Pied Piper Art Academy. I have just finished my 12th standard and I'm 18, and well, these are some of my works.
What made you to become an artist?
Actually, I was always interested in art. When I was younger, I used to draw behind my sketchbook. And, well, I wanted to pursue art as a career. And, well, when I was in 10th standard, I had planned to join an art academy just to prepare a portfolio for the college. So during my 11th standard, I found this class. And actually, I had been to this class when I was younger, but I gave up because of the studies. But since I had taken, like, in 11th standard, I had some time, so I joined the academy, and Sir Wilson, he showed me my talent for figurative art and abstracts. And for this exhibition, I have decided to be full abstract. So I've used different mediums and try to create different looks.
What would you like to be in future? Are you really passionate about being an artist, or have you have anything else in your mind?
Well, I was very passionate, and I still am, about being pursuing art. But after I met Sir Wilson, he analyzed my art, and he told me that, like, what I need is talking. Like, I need to learn to write. So he said, like, for me, it's better to do something in English literature or psychology or something, so I can use those elements in my art. And for masters, I can do fine art or whatever, anything related to art. So that's my plan for now. So I'll be applying for some colleges to pursue English literature that I can use it for my art.
So from this art, what you want to see? What is that? What do you want to explain about your art?
So this artwork, first of all, it's oil paint on canvas. It's called the intermingling of those two. So here, those two refers to these two colors, which is pink and blue. So what happens when you think of pink, it's like we say like, oh, it's for girls, it's a girly color, and blue is for boys. So these colors have been given gender roles, which is just unfair, right? So here I've shown the colors arguing and fighting for their own identities. So they don't want to be like termed as I'm a girly color. So they are like fighting with each other. They are like, I also want to be part of that. And then there is black color here, which is trying to control them, which is the reality. But at some point, like the black color loses, and these two colors, they have overpowered it, and they are fighting with each other. So it's just like intermingling of those two.
And regarding the rest of your paintings, what do you see?
Sorry?
Rest of your paintings, what do you see?
The paintings are basically based on the theme of our exhibition, which is the hill. So what the hill refers to is that it's not literally the hill, climbing the hill, but it's more like the ups and downs in life. Like sometimes we think that, oh, we are like, it's everything is going well, so that's like climbing up the hill, but then we suddenly fall down. And once you climb up the hill, you attain a successful life or something, you have an option whether to stay up there or try something new, whether it could be like going like to a higher hill or falling down, tumbling down completely. So all of my works, like this work here, it's called Notion of Heights, and this one is called Notion of Heights too. These are both works showing my progress. So these were done in the between 6 months, there's a gap. This was done like when I had just joined, and this was done 6 months after I joined. So it shows the progress. And even these works, it shows the human condition, how we struggle to find our identity, like how we grow, we try to like become popular and everything, but then we lose ourselves. Like this work, where I was the one who could not choose. So when I was working on it, it was coming on very figurative. I could see a nice figure in that. But then I had decided to make my exhibition abstract based. So I had to make it abstract, like I had to take out the identity of the figure. So that's why I wrote it, the one who could not choose, the figure lost its identity.
So what message would like you give?
For me personally, to people, like since I have done abstracts, I would say don't be afraid to try abstracts. Like it's really fun and it's something you can connect to. Like, you know, like people say abstracts, they don't sell, they are useless, I can't connect to it. How can you not connect to abstracts? Every day you can see the work, there is a different perspective to the work. Like, for example, if you see a figure, like a person standing, like it's the same figure every day you see it. But abstracts, you can see it from different dimensions. You can play with colors and you can express your emotions more clearly through abstracts. So I would say go try them out. Don't be afraid.
Yeah, lastly, what you want to say that all female that you have come together to do this exhibition, what you want to say to your members?
Yes. So all the other members of the exhibition, we have been together for like quite some time, except for one member who she joined a month back, but we connected so well on a greater level. And then Sir Wilson, he recommended that, okay, we should have an exhibition, and it was awesome. We bonded well, we connected to each other, and we came to know about each other's weaknesses and strengths. And this whole exhibition shows like we five females who have come together, we show our strengths. And like various, like most of us, we have our responsibilities, and as girls, and there is a lady, she has kids, she still came to class, she did her work. So it just shows like how powerful we all can be when we are together.
Exhibition, what
about
this? How do you like it?
Okay. Yeah. You know, how we started, my daughter was very much interested in painting. So no doubt she did civil engineering, and then, you know, after that she did some work and all these things. But you know, he loved painting like anything. So she started with the painting work at home, and then to get the actual the feel of the painting, how professionally it can be done. You know, then she joined Wilson. Yeah. So, and then she was very happy here that, you know, she learned a lot of good thing about paintings, you know, like, you know, oil painting, then color painting. I don't know the details of all the paintings, you know. But, you know, I was very happy that the all five budding young girls came together and made this exhibition. And I hope, you know, and I fully agree that, you know, it will be a big success for them for future to do a better paintings and do bigger exhibitions, you know. Okay, thank you very much.
It's very heartening to see young ladies getting together and producing this wonderful show. It's very encouraging, and we wish them all the best. It's very nice. We found it, some of the art pieces showing creativity in the future, and I'm sure they'll go a long way. All the very best to them.
Yeah.
Okay, I take this opportunity to thank everyone who made it a success. Let us start by saying Coco. Coco was there. All he knows about each artist. Coco is German, and I don't know if I can say it, but we got to see a great man's work. He's got a collection of world-renowned artists, and he actually made us touch it. And I thank the parents, I thank the people who have always supported in the background, people who have helped us to, you know, bring out the best in framing. They suggested rates, and I'm happy that works have got sold. Again, Coco is, you know, he knows that they are young. If a youngster sells a work, it's a boost. It's like, you know, putting a star on the hand of a child. My first work I sold for 500 rupees. So today it is that way. Thank you to everyone who has made this show a success. The press, I shouldn't forget the press. Okay? Anyone else wants to talk?
Yeah.
Let them. Yeah.
And I mean, we all as a group, we all thank our sir who has guided us through the. I mean, because of him, I don't think so it would have been possible that we are here. Even though I'm from art college, I never got this platform. But because of him, I think it is all possible. And we all come from different backgrounds, but still he managed to put us up. And I mean. The amount of works and the versatile works that we have got here, I think all thanks to him. And
I don't think it was an easy job to get people from different age groups, different backgrounds getting together and working on one common goal, which was this exhibition. And the best part is you see variety in everybody's work. Whatever a talent we have or whatever skill we had, sir has helped us to bring that out and nurture that, rather than being like somebody else. We are all our individual self, and that's what is portrayed in our art. And Pied Piper Academy has been the platform for us to do this, and hopefully from here we will get a little more exposure, as so many people are seeing our work, and we hope to go forward from here. It's journey upwards.
I just want to take the opportunity to thank everyone who have helped us put the show up, and especially sir for mentoring us through this whole journey. And it's unbelievable what we've achieved in a span of 40 days. It's truly unbelievable. Probably people take years and years to get where we are today. As non art people from non-art background except Mrinal, and I'm very fortunate to be here, and I mean so we all are, and like everyone said, Sir has guided us in a way that he brought out the best in each of us and our personalities out and let us be ourselves in the form of our art, than put in the techniques and learnings which is taught academically. So yes, very fortunate, and there's a lot of gratitude. Thank you.
Thank everyone involved in the show, sir, and all of us, because it took a lot of effort, I'm sure, to bring a bunch of like different and odd individuals together and get them to work on like one specific projects, and just the number of hours and everything we've all spent together, it's been like a very unique bonding experience for all of us, while simultaneously really honing our creativity and technical skills in the process to reach like this level of art. So I like really want to thank all of you for being a part of this and being a part of this experience.
So I would like to thank Sir first of all for letting us like, use his premises for the whole day, every day, and like, actually having a lot of patience teaching us all the mediums. We learned so much in just 1 month, and it was so amazing working with all of the participants. It was such a great experience, and yeah, we bonded well. It was nice. Then also, I'm really glad for all the opportunities that I've gotten so far in this class, meeting all the people, meeting Coco, and for him to buying my work, and also all the other participants like Divya, Mrinal, Meenakshi, Divya Kamath, and so it's been a great journey. Thank you.